Mistake. Yes, that's right. There are top 5 biggest mistakes that you should never do from stage that pushes the audience to bore zone. And they think, can you please stop speaking? And in that situation, your experience, your expertise will count for nothing if you mess up on the stage. So let's get aware of those 5 mistakes before you make them. And one bonus tip at the end, which is a solution to these 5 mistakes. I have possibly made each one of these mistakes at some point in my career while speaking from stage. And I know how it feels. It's like wearing shoes in your hands. That's a big mistake. You would never do that. So here is mistake number 1. Being Mr. Exaggerator. Most people don't speak to the point. This is a sin. Literally, like committing suicide on the stage. They go on and on, round and round in circle. Never gives a full stop. And you know, some people are so much in love with themselves that they will tell you everything. Right from the name of their first great teacher to the name of their first crush. Please, spare the audience these details. Too much of unnecessary information is unnecessary. It does not serve a purpose and leaves the audience confused and dissatisfied. So it is critical to stick to the point and deliver short, crisp, and well-scripted speech. This way, you will hear louder applause. Oh, thank you. Here's mistake number 2. Being Mr. Disconnected. Most people don't speak in a language that connects. Now, this is subtle and most often overlooked. Think of this way. How would you explain quantum physics to 6-year-olds? You would go down to their level and speak in a language or vocabulary that 6-year-olds would understand, right? Same goes with public speaking. Every industry, every age group has few words or vocabulary that might be completely different from the way you talk. So get to know your audience beforehand and pepper your speech with the words that will quickly be absorbed by your audience. This way, you will be able to get your point across very effectively by building a good connection with your audience. Here is mistake number 3. Being Mr. Awkward. Let me start with the fact. 93% of our communication is non-verbal. And yet, we speakers don't make eye contact. Looking nervous, disinterested, slouching, or fidgeting or pacing around on the stage. Imagine this scenario. Say you're attending a talk and the speaker comes in looking like this. Not a pretty picture, right? Quite uninspiring, I should say. And then if I come to you looking like this, you would probably listen better. That is how much of a difference body language makes. Well, by the way, I hope I did a good job on showing you Mr. Awkward and Mr. Non-Awkward. If you think I did a good job, type "good job, Nikhil" in the comment section below. And if I did a bad job, type "bad job, Nikhil" or "worse job." But you get the idea. So don't be Mr. Awkward. Make eye contact. Keep your posture upright, smile, and please, please don't fidget or pace around on the stage like a mouse in a cage. Yeah, like that. Mistake number 4, being Mr. Scattered Brain. Not being organized in your speech, not having structure. An unorganized speech never ever works, period. I attended one of the talks long back on how to up your sales figure. Well, I went there expecting a concrete solutions but came back disappointed. as the speaker kept talking about the challenges he had faced as a sales manager and various other problems his product had encountered. It was clear to me that his speech was going nowhere. If only he had taken time and come up with solid strategies and organized his speech to give us a specifics, we would have come back wiser. So structure will help you deliver the speech that is to the point and get your point across without confusion. So have a clear beginning, body, and conclusion. All right? Here is mistake number 5, being Mr. Self-Obsessed. Not taking audience's feedback while delivering the speech. Speakers miss out on this very critical thing. When they come, they speak and they leave without inkling into whether their message was reached to their audience or not. You're not talking or delivering your speech to the walls or empty chairs in the auditorium. These are living people listening to you, and getting their reaction is key to delivering a better speech. And you can involve your audience in multiple ways. You can ask questions, like rhetorical questions, or just have a raise of hands or something else. All right? And my dear friend, there is just one thing you can do to avoid all these above 5 mistakes. And that is by being Mr. Mindful. When you are mindful on the stage, you are aware of the environment you are speaking in. You are aware of the audience's reaction, and you are aware of the way you are presenting yourself. And that is my bonus tip to you. Being Mr. Mindful will help you serve an almost perfectly delectable speech. And this is an oversight on most part of the speakers. I remember I was delivering a talk in India, and I asked the audience, they would want me to speak in English or Hindi. Most part of the audiences said Hindi. And I have no idea why I kept talking in English. No wonder why I did not get a louder applause. So being Mr. Mindful will help you constantly aware of where you are and what you are speaking, no matter if you are communicating one-on-one or from stage. That's it. No more wearing shoes in your hands. There they are. 5 biggest mistakes you should never do. Don't forget to grab a free PDF copy of this video topic. Link is shared in the section below. Make sure you grab it. And if you are already a subscribed member of Success Wheels, then this email is already sitting in your inbox. Make sure you check it out.